Hello everyone, Alex here with another quick tip, and in this quick tip we're going to be testing out the MSP19U with Toonboom Software. Just so you know, this is the tablet that I'm going to be working on, MSP19U by Yiynova. The website is yiynova.com, and this is the tablet that I'm talking about here. One quick point before we get started. There's two versions of this tablet. One is the MSP19, the other one is the MSP19U. This one I've heard has totally different technology than this one, so I am not sure if this one will work or not. I've heard that it does not with Toonboom software, but this one here is the one we're going to be testing out, so we will find out how it works. I just got my tablet a couple of days ago. I have ran some tests on Toonboom software, and I'm going to show you what I came across. Before we get started, though, I'm going to show you my setup here as far as displays are concerned. If you right-click in Windows 7 here on the screen, you'll get the and click resolution, screen resolution, you'll get this screen right here that shows you the display, the resolution. This is the highest the tablet can go. So I have it right now on multiple displays. Alright, that being said, I'm going over to Animate Pro, and with the pen tablet in my hand, I'm going to try and work on Storyboard Pro with the tablet so you see what happens. Okay, so let's get started here. And this is initially what I got when I first I fired up the Animate Pro with the tablet installed. I was able to make the first stroke. The second stroke you cannot make any longer. And no matter where I touch on the screen, unless I touch on the outside of the screen here. But if I draw on this side, you see how I'm drawing on the right side of the screen, and it's actually coming out on the left side of the screen. So I'm on the right side, and you see that the brush is coming out on the left side. Not a good thing, not what you would want. In Storyboard Pro, you make one line, second line impossible to make. If you wait a couple of seconds, you might be able to squeeze out another line, and there you go, but then you cannot make no more. Same thing if I draw outside of the work area, you'll see them. I'm drawing on the left side, on the right side, and then lines are coming out on the left. After a bunch of tests, I did figure out that there is a way around this. And the way around it is to set this to single display, show desktop on only one, hit apply, and keep changes. And I'm going to restart. And when I say restart, I mean I'm going to close out of... by doing this, my second monitor just shut off, so I no longer have a dual monitor display. If you have a dual monitor display before, then you'll know what all this means. But for those of you that have not, multiple displays, show display on only one, this is the tablet, this is my second monitor. This right here shuts off my second monitor. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to try it again. It's not going to work, same thing. But if I restart Animate Pro, you'll see what happens, and also Storyboard Pro. To do that, I'm going to go ahead and pause the video real quickly. When I come back on, I would have done this to both of them, because it takes a second here. Well, actually, let me try it. If it gives me any problems, I guess I can just edit the video here. All right, so now everything's off. We're going to start the programs up all over again. Okay, we got Animate Pro up, and we're going to try Storyboard Pro up as well. Let's see which one comes up first, who's going to behave today. Alright, so Animate Pro is up. Let's get Storyboard Pro running. Now remember, this is again with the setting. I'm opening up both programs with this setting, show desktop on only one. And what happens when I try that now, now that I've set my display to a single monitor, I'm going to go ahead and... Okay, so look at what happens here. Nice, beautiful line with pressure sensitivity and everything here. Look, see the. If I draw outside, it draws where it's supposed to. And so that's working pretty good with this setting. Show desktop on only one. And let's see how Animate Pro, Storyboard Pro likes it. Same thing with Storyboard Pro. So the key is to have it on a on this setting here, show desktop on only one. Now, if you really want to have your second monitor working, once you've opened the program up, either one, either just Animate Pro or Storyboard Pro or any Toonboom software in this setting, once you already have it up, you can actually go ahead and extend these displays again. Hit apply. Keep changes. And if we, I just had a nasty crash there. But by setting that display, to extended displays, my second monitor is now open. And if I, and I'm able to put stuff on there and sell, you know, extra real estate, I could drag my browser over to the next window and I can use my second monitor. Now, if I were to turn, if I was to shut off Animate Pro completely, reboot it, and open it up again in this setting, I would have the same problem that I had initially with the drawing pen. So, the key is, if you have a Yiynova MSP19U and you're using Toonboom software, make sure to set the setting to single show desktop on one, turn the program on, draw something just to verify that it's working, and then go ahead and change it to extended displays. An extra step to take, but I think one that's worth it because this tablet is only retails at $599. Its equivalent, which is the Wacom Cintiq, is three times that. So you make up your mind if you're willing to go the extra step to get this thing to work for and save what is it, $1,200 or something like that. That's the decision you have to make. I would think this would be something simple to fix. I think it's if Toonboom and Yiynova ever spoke, they'll probably find a driver or something, something they could do to fix this problem. So in the meantime, this is the workaround. I got this tablet for $599 on Amazon, and I am happy with it. Every other program works: Photoshop, Flash, Art Rage. I did have the same kind of problem with Sketchbook Pro that I'm having here with Toonboom. You have to do the same thing with Sketchbook Pro, but again, there you have it. The tablet does work with Toonboom software. You do get pressure sensitivity, but you have to do that extra step. All right, hopefully this helps. Make up your mind on whether to get the Yiynova MSP19U. This has been Alex with another quick tip, and I'll see you on the next one.